okay, really. So got to be quick. All right, so, yeah, we had this one assignment that was pretty tough. So it was a real thinking assignment, all about sample spaces. I gave lots of marks just for thinking, if I saw you thinking. Thinking is good. I think, therefore I am. René Descartes, he was a kind of famous mathematician. All right. So all this thinking will be gets consolidated in the next lessons there when we learn how to properly count things using the fundamental counting principle, permutations, combinations. But I wanted you to see how you can always use the brute force drawing method, just thinking. And, of course, after a couple hundred years, we figured out easier ways to do it. But you'll never be wrong to draw it out seriously using sample spaces and drawings and graphic organizers. So there was the first question. The first question was that one. Animate. There we go. So that was easy. What are all the possible outcomes on a die? All right, let me just race through that. There you go. You could have that, or if you wanted to draw the pretty pictures on the face of the dice, you could do that. Usually we put sets of things in curly brackets. So if you want to calculate the probability that it's greater than 4, that means greater than 4 means 5 or 6. 4 is not greater than itself. So, of course, you know how to count probability. You calculate probability. You take the number of outcomes that are what you want, bigger than 4, divide it by the total. So I see two things that are bigger than 4. So that's 2 out of every 6, and you always reduce fractions. Always, always reduce fractions. There's a button on your calculator, does it? All right, let's keep going here. All right, how about this one here? And we sometimes call tree diagrams. That's a form of a graphic organizer. In other words, there's other ways to do it besides just trees. You can do tables, whatever. I've seen students invent wonderful ways to organize their thoughts. All right, so let's try this one then. Here we go. Well, there's what I came up with. Here it comes. There we go. Here, let me speed through it. Blah, 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 blah. There's all my possibilities. All right, so it's painful. I know it's painful, yes. But for now, you've got to kind of do it the hard way so that when you learn the easy way, you'll better appreciate stuff. If you always do it the easy way, that's what makes rivers and men crooked. The easy way is not always the best way. In any event, let's see what we're doing here. So, yeah, so I made the tree, so all the possibilities, right? Pepperoni and tomato, pepperoni and pepper, pepperoni and onion, ham and tomato, ham and peppers, ham, etc. You could list them all. So the probability that you're going to get a bacon tomato is, there's only one bacon tomato there. Where is it? That's my favorite. Right there. There's only one out of a total 12. So it's 1 out of 12 probability. And that's some percent. I don't bother doing percents usually. Later on, you'll learn how to count how many there are. You'd say there's 4 times 3 choices. Oh, there's 12. So you can actually circumvent actually drawing the diagram just by doing a little bit of simple math. 4 choices times 3 choices for each of the 4 choices is 12 total choices. Oh, that'll be, you haven't learned that yet. And I skipped Arlen's wardrobe there because I got to get to school. Here's Bob, right? Bob's going to go to school. He didn't study last night, and he gets to the last couple of questions and he has to guess. All right, so read and do. Did you get this? So there's what I came up with. Here's one way to do it. I'm going to make a graphic organizer. You ready? I'm going to start guessing. So my first guess could be, let's see, the first, I might get it correct or not correct. Right? Remember how we put a bar over something? That means not correct. And the second question, I might get it correct or not correct. And the third question, I might get it correct or not correct or not correct. And right, so there's all those possibilities. They're independent outcomes. We'll learn about independent outcomes later. So this is what you call a tree or a graphic organizer. You're organizing your thoughts graphically. So if I was to list all the outcomes, right, I would have, here's what I would have. There they all are. Check it out. So those are all, there should be, shouldn't there be eight of them? Yeah, there should be eight, shouldn't there? Because, well, later on we'll learn to say, well, there was two times two times two is eight. Oh, yeah. And then you don't have to list them all, usually. So how many outcomes are there? How many outcomes are all correct? Well, I only see one branch where they're all correct. The CCC branch. Only one out of those eight possible outcomes, equally likely, is all correct. So the probability of correct, correct, correct is one out of eight. So we'll be learning how to do all that, but I wanted you to see that sometimes you got to use the old brute force method. And, you know, so I've had students do it this way too. Right? Nobody says you've got to do it. Whatever you're doing to organize your thoughts will make me happy. Well, it'll make you happy. And then obviously you can just transpose all the check marks for the X's, if you know what I mean. There'd be eight ways that way too. So whatever way you manage to graphically organize your thoughts and think is up to you. I find the trees a lot better though. In these particular circumstances. All right, let's try this one here. Now, this one was, well, actually, this one was, a lot of people tried it, and a lot of people got close. I like it. Thank you. So, sorry for making you think. Here we go. Let's try it. Oh, man, let's get busy. All right. So, I'm going to start my tree. Are you ready? There it goes, zing, 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 zing. Look at that. Okay, there. See what I got there so far? Oh, there's what I got so far. But hey, isn't this really kind of like this? Well, let me back this up a bit, right? So I did the tree. Right, now, isn't the tree really just the same as pathways that we did? Except you're not trying to get to a particular corner. You're just taking four steps. One, two, three, four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're trying to figure out where you end up. Oh my goodness, you could have just used Pascal on this. Funny enough, you could use combinations. Oh wow. Anyway, just thinking, just saying. All right, so then you could branch all these left, right, sounds like army drill here. All right, there we go. So you end up with all that stuff, and where are we at here? All right, let's do that. So it turns out that, well, you can follow all this, right? If I said, how many times does the mouse turn left? And when I say, does the mouse turn left, I mean only left, right? So how many times does the mouse turn left only three times? And so I did that in purple, all right? So I did some, I circled the purple outcomes, or events rather, where it was all three lefts. And can I animate that a bit more? Right, so there was number one. Well, let me fix this up. There was number one, two, three, and don't forget that one over there. All right. So it turns out you could do all this, and it is ugly. So you'll follow this. You'll figure this out. So four outcomes have three lefts. Right, there's that branch, that branch, that branch, and don't forget the one that starts with a right and has three lefts. Right, later on you'll learn that that's a combo. You could say that's a four combo three. All right, later on you'll learn how to calculate all these without actually having to draw the trees. That's later. How about all rights? Well, there's only one branch that is all rights out of a total of 16 possible, so that's one out of 16. How about the probability that it alternates? So alternating means you got a left, right, or a right, left, right, left. Right? Isn't there only going to be two of those? You could count them. Uh-oh, here about this one. What's the probability the mouse turns right at most three times? So at most means no more than three times. So no more than three times means zero times, one time, or three times, which means not four times. Oh, we got some logic going on here. Did you hear what I said? At most three times means no times, right? One time, right? Two times, right? Or three times, right? But not four times, right? Well, we already said that four times, right, was 1 out of 16. So not four times, right, is going to be 15 out of 60. Oh, my goodness. Don't you love this stuff? All right, enough of that. I better get this. Oh, here, we better do this one here, too. All right, so here's another way to do a sample space with a table. All right, so I'm going to put an X when she misses the bus and a tick mark when she gets the bus. So obviously, if Tina arrives at 13 minutes after the hour and the bus left there at 10 minutes after the hour, she missed it. And then she missed it. The only time she catches the bus is when she gets there just on time. So she misses the bus all those times. But look, she does catch the bus a couple times. Look, right there. So if she gets there at 13 minutes after and the bus does, she gets the bus. If she gets there at 13 after and the bus gets there at 14 after, she gets the bus. If she gets there at 13 minutes after and the bus gets there at 15 after, she still catches the bus. So notice there's going to be like, how many is that? That's going to be 6 rows of 4. That's going to be 24 possible events that could happen. And how many of them where she catches the bus? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 out of 24, you always reduce 1 out of 4, 25%. Okay, I got to get to school. Where'd we go here? That was fun. Bright light.